we may bring you the following special sports presentation of Phillies baseball on Fox 29.
From Flushing, New York, it's time for baseball with the Phillies and the Mets at Shea Stadium.
Oh, watch that baby. Oh, mercy. Upper deck.
Ground ball is short. This could be it. As one, as two.
Today's game with the Phillies and the Mets is brought to you by Busch Beer. Head for the mountains of Busch. By Ford. Bank on your Quality Plus Ford dealer for great savings during Leadership Month. By the Bell of Pennsylvania Yellow Pages. No other book can match it. Bell of Pennsylvania, a Bell Atlantic company. And by Dodge. Rediscover American values at your local Dodge dealer. Where it's advantage, Dodge. From Shea Stadium in New York, welcome to Phillies baseball this afternoon. Game two of the series, the Phillies and the New York Mets. Jason Grimsley goes for the Phils, Frank Viola for New York. Harry Callis along with Rich Ashburn. And Rich, a great opening day game really yesterday. The Phillies have a lot to be proud of. It's a shame they lost the ball game.
Yeah, they played a good ball game. It was a good ball game to watch. And anytime you get a Doc Gooden going, you're going to have possibly a tough day, and but it's a shame they lost the way they lost. They lost on a double steal by two guys that don't run very well, Hubie Brooks and Tommy Herr. And I think had the Phillies executed a little better defensively, had Dutch Dalton looked Hubie Brooks back at third momentarily, then it wouldn't have happened. And that's unusual for Dutch. Dutch is a very heady catcher. So, that's the way it goes sometimes. Don Gooden has a way of making a bad team, mediocre team, or a good team look good on any given day. Now, I don't think you can really judge the Mets by what happened yesterday either. They didn't do much either.
Terry Mulholland pitched an outstanding game yesterday. If he continues to pitch that way, he will win a lot of games. Of course, he lost yesterday's opener. And our colleague Andy Musser had a chance to talk to Terry about that opening day assignment.
Thank you very much, Harry. Terry Mulholland is here. Terry, you lost the game yesterday, but you pitched a whale of a ball game, and I think the Phillies are hoping that you pitch that kind of game again. How do you feel upon reflecting about yesterday?
I'd like to pitch that kind of game again, all except for the first two hitters of the game. I felt that I made two mistake pitches to both Jeffries and Coleman, and it probably cost me the ball game.
The balls were up a little bit. A couple of breaking balls were up, right?
Yeah, it was just a case of being a little too pumped up, too much adrenaline in the first inning, and really not being able to stay back long enough to get my arm up and through on my off-speed stuff, particularly my changeup and my curveball.
And yet, as the game wore along, you made quite a few of the hitters look bad. I recall in particular Vince Coleman looking bad on a curveball, and also Kevin McReynolds looking pretty bad.
Yeah, Coleman particularly in the first inning, first at bat, I had him, set up the way I wanted to have him set up at the time, and the pitch that he hit was a hanging curveball on the outside, and all I needed to do was get that into the dirt, and I'm sure that my chances of striking him out were a lot greater had I gotten that pitch down. And the same with McReynolds. Right now, with the curveball and the changeup and the off-speed stuff that I'm throwing along with my fastball and slider, I'm able to offset some hitters, get them off balance, and hopefully, within a few starts, I'll be able to really hone in on what I'm doing with both those pitches and set some more guys up.
One of the highlights of your day yesterday, I'm sure, was a stolen base.
Yeah, it was the first. They didn't let me pick up the bag or anything. Hojo came up to me and said, "Yeah, I suppose now you feel like you're Vince Coleman and you're going to be doing this on a regular basis." And I said, "Yeah, right." Yeah. But it was a surprise. I think I was more surprised before I made the attempt when I got the sign from Boa at third. I saw the sign and I sat there and I kind of like I didn't just see that, did I? And luckily Vukovic came up and said, yeah, you're going. So.
You're going. Okay, just another notch in the scrapbook. Harry, back to you.
All right, thanks, Andy. And Nick Lave has said the newest Philly, Mitch Williams, who arrived at the game 2 hours before game time yesterday, he would not be afraid to use. He used him, and I think the wild thing's going to give us some excitement this summer, Rich.
He's a guy that can scare the hitters, and I know there are Phillies hitters who are very happy to see him over here so they don't have to face him. He only faced Dave Magadan, and he just saw the bat right off in his hands. He hit him right on the trademark there, and he's going to do a lot of that.
Bills and the Mets game two, Grimsley against Viola. Starting lineups right after these messages.
Baseball isn't always easy, or painless, or pretty. But with two boxes of Kellogg's Frosted Flakes or Kellogg's Raisin Bran, baseball's free. Just tip the vouchers from the box, redeem them for a ticket, and you're in the game. Choose from any of these exciting dates. See package for more details. So don't drop the ball. Catch a free game. But hurry, this offer's going. Kellogg's Frosted Flakes and Kellogg's Raisin Bran, your ticket to the game.
The lineup cards have been exchanged at home plate. Here are the starting lineups for this afternoon's game. For Nick Leva's Phils, it'll be Lenny Dykstra leading off in center field. Darren Dalton will catch and bat second. Bon Hayes in left field hitting third. Dale Murphy, right fielder, bats fourth. John Kruk at first base will hit fifth. Charlie Hayes, the third baseman, batting sixth. Dickie Thon at shortstop will hit seventh. Randy Reddy will start at second base today. He'll bat eighth and batting ninth and pitching. Jason Grimsley. Grimsley was 8-5 at Grand Wilkes-Barre last year, a 3.93 ERA. After joining the Phils, he went 3-2 with a very fine 3.30 earned run mark. For the New York Mets of Bud Harrelson, Vince Coleman, the center fielder, leads off. Craig Jeffries at third base will bat second. Dave Magadan will be at first base. He'll hit third. Hubie Brooks, right fielder, batting fourth. Howard Johnson at shortstop hits fifth. Mark Carrion will be in left field. He'll bat sixth. Kevin McReynolds is still out with a strained right kneecap. He's on a day-to-day basis. Tom Herr, the second baseman, hits seventh. Charlie O'Brien will catch and bat eighth. And batting ninth and pitching, sweet music, Frank Viola. Viola coming off a fine year in which he went 20-12 with an ERA of 2.67. The umpires, and good to see the Major League umpires back. Bruce Fremming calling the balls and strikes. Ed Montague at first base. Dana DeMuth at second. And at third, Greg Bonan. Frank Viola, he'll be 31 in 10 days. One thing this guy gives you is not only a lot of wins, but a lot of innings. He has pitched 200 or more innings for 8 straight years. That's tops in the major leagues. So here's a guy that does not break down. Great strikeout walk ratio. He throws fastball, slider, and his out pitch is an outstanding changeup, probably the best in the game. He was 1-1 this spring with a 4.50 ERA. The Mets did not hit at all this spring. They batted just 240. That was last in the National League in the Grapefruit and Cactus League, but their staff ERA was the best at 3.09. Conversely, the Phillies hit well, hitting 286, but their ERA was the highest among National League teams in the Cactus and Grapefruit Leagues at 5.88.
The guy that showed Viola how to throw that changeup is the Phillies pitching coach, Johnny Padres. Trying to show the Phillies pitchers how to deliver that pitch. Johnny.
Lenny Dykstra will lead off. Dykstra admittedly has trouble against Frank Viola. Viola is a left-hander. A lot of times left-hand pitchers will not throw their changeup to left-hand hitters, but not the case with Viola. He will use that change against left-hand hitters, and Dykstra said it's extremely difficult to pick up. Lenny Lifetime is 4-for-18 against Viola. 5 strikeouts, and that's unusual because Lenny does not punch out very often. And the first pitch of the ball game is a fastball for a strike.
Viola is pitching with bone chips in his elbow, and I guess they're passive right now, but there's some fear that he might have some elbow troubles before it's all over.
One ball and one strike to Lenny Dykstra. Lenny in the opener was 0-for-4. Did make a sensational defensive play. A very strong throw, gunning down Darryl Boston at third base. 2 balls and a strike. Viola Lifetime against the Phillies is 3 up and 2 down. One of his losses was a very weird game in which he walked a career-high 7 batters in the game. First hit he gave up was a grand slam homer to Dickie Fallon. 3-1 to Lenny D. Lenny might even take this 3-1 pitch. Aaron Dalton waiting on deck.
I think if he gets a good pitch, he'll try to hit it. He wants to get that first base hit.
It was a 3-1 breaking ball. So Lenny is a leadoff base runner with a walk.
Looked like it sailed a little bit. I don't think it was a slider. Don't think it was a cut fastball. But sometimes his fastball will sail.
Here's Darren Dalton. Dalton Lifetime 4-for-12 off Viola. On 1-for-4 in the opener last year. Or last yesterday.
Four of the first 5 hitters for the Phillies are left-hand hitters today. So Nick Leyva going with what he considers his best lineup, no matter which arm the pitcher throws with. Maybe the only change is Randy Reddy for Wally Backman.
All right, here we go.
Missed again. 2-0.
He's wild low. A lot of pitchers, most pitchers get wild high, but he's wild low today so far.
Charlie O'Brien out to talk to Frank Viola, and Tom Hertrott's in from second base. Buddy Harrelson in his first full year as manager of the New York Mets. Took over on May 29th for Davey Johnson last year.
He's changed this team's style. I don't think there's any doubt about that. He's not going to sit around and wait for the 3-run homer.
That is low.
See, he wants that pitch from Bruce Fremming. It was borderline low.
To Darren Dalton. Dalton has a pretty good eye. They might send Lenny Dykstra here on this 3-1 pitch. Darren was 10th in the National League in walks last year. Viola thinks he might be going. He holds, Dalton rips it to right field, but foul.
Well, he just missed that one. He had a fat 3-1 pitch to hit. Ripped it foul.
Full count to Darren Dalton. And Lenny Dykstra will be moving, I would expect, on this pitch. Yeah. There he goes, swing, another line drive foul. Next will come back and they'll try it again. See why the Mets play Dalton around to the right to pull. See how far off the line Mark Carrion is. Coleman well over in right center.
Takes him out of a hole. And this O'Brien can flat out throw. Well, Johnson had a little trouble getting the tag on Lenny. I'm not so sure he was out. Like Lenny may have had that hand under there, but the ball beat him, and they usually will call you out.
Von Hayes takes a low change up, 1-0. Guy really gives Von Hayes trouble. Last year, Von was 1-for-13 off Viola, and Frank struck him out 7 times in 13 at bats. 1-1.
Key to that double play was the 3-2 pitch that Viola made on Dalton. It was borderline outside, and I think Dutch thought it was outside, but too close to take, obviously.
To shallow right, Hubie Brooks can't catch up to it as Hayes drops a single into right field. A looper, but he'll take it.
Broke his bat on it. I think it was a changeup. He was fooled on it. You see kind of an awkward swing here at it. But it was an off-speed pitch. And that's going to be, I think, a problem for New York this year is Hubie Brooks does not cover much ground in right field. He's not an aggressive right fielder either.
That'll bring up Dale Murphy. Murph lifetime 3-for-9 off Viola, including a home run. He went 1-for-4 in the opener yesterday.
Like I said, Hubie Brooks.
Hubie Brown, basketball color analyst, and a brilliant one. I think the way the outfield plays, I mean, not only Hubie Brooks, but Vince Coleman plays a really deep center field. I think there are going to be a lot of singles that fall in front of those outfields, right? In New York.
Yeah, they're a long way out there.
One ball and one strike to Dale Murphy. Base with 2 outs here in the first. Change up for him. 1-2 to Murphy.
Good location. Great arm speed. See, that's what sets up the changeup. That's what deceives the hitter.
Line away. Great to see the major league umpires back working. 4-year contract. We'd also like to commend and give our kudos to the amateurs that worked our game yesterday. They did a fine job. To shortstop, Howard Johnson. Hojo juggles, recovers in time to get Murphy, and that will retire the side. No runs, one hit. No errors, one left. After one half, goes nothing. New York coming to bat. This telecast is presented by Authority of the Phillies and may not be rebroadcast in any form without the express written consent of the Phillies and WTXF Fox 29 in Philadelphia. Jason Grimsley doing the pitching for Nick Leyva this afternoon. Facing kind of a surprise number two starter in this rotation. But he pitched his way into the starting rotation with a pretty good spring. Grimsley, 23 years of age, from Cleveland, Texas, and Vince Coleman will be the first one to face him. Charlie Hayes plays him shallow at third to take the bunt away from the fleet switch hitter. One ball and no strikes to Coleman. Grimsley lifetime in the major leagues, 4-5. He is 0-2 lifetime against New York. A little tapper right back at Jason. Coleman is retired. That's one down. And it will bring up Greg Jeffries, also a switch hitter. Went 1-for-4 in the opener yesterday, driving in a run with a double. Grimsley really matured during the winter and spring. With a lot of confidence. Really pitched well all spring except for one game in Plant City where the wind was blowing out about 60 miles an hour. He was trying to be too fine that day and gave up quite a few runs. That's a game in which the Phillies hit six home runs and lost the game. Good breaking ball, 1-2.
Throwing a lot of those curve balls early.
The Doc, who won the opener yesterday, 2-1. Struck him out with a good breaking ball. That's two quick outs, and it'll bring on Dave Magadan.
Yeah, this ball bounced up there. Good pick there by Dalton.
Magadan took the collar on opening day, 0-for-4. Third leading hitter in the league last year behind Willie McGee and Eddie Murray. Hit .328. Jason is throwing strikes so far. That's really about all he has to do to be a winner in this league is to throw strikes. He's got good stuff, good natural movement with his fastball. 1-1.
He pitched well enough to win most games yesterday.
Two balls and a strike. Two to Magadan. Magadan just opened up a restaurant in his home city of Tampa. struck him out. Two strikeouts in the inning for Grimsley. No runs, hits, or errors, and none left. After one, it's nothing, nothing.
In my 13 years in the big leagues, I've seen teams with a lot of different styles and makeups. What I like about the 1991 Phillies is that we've got a good blend of veterans and talented young guys. I think it can be a fun year. I know I'm looking forward to it.
Friday, April 12th, 7:35, the Phillies home opener. Always one of the biggest nights of the year. Enjoy the festivities, watch the Phillies play the Cardinals, and get a handsome Lenny Dykstra Dale Murphy poster courtesy of IGA. Call 463-1000.
Pause for station identification on the Phillies television network.
WTXF, Fox 29 in Philadelphia.
John Kruk leads off for the Phillies' second inning. Went 1-for-4 yesterday, a homer accounting for the Phillies' lone run.
Oh, wow.
Low breaking ball, one strike to Kruk. Our trivia question of the afternoon, who was the only pitcher to beat the Mets twice at Shea Stadium last year? Pop up into shallow left field, and Carry On calls off Howard Johnson and makes the play. One down, it'll bring up Charlie Hayes. Slings a base hit into center field. Charlie Hayes is a one-out base runner with his first hit of the year, and it'll bring on Dickie Thon. Dickie has not had many hits off Viola lifetime. He's a 182 lifetime hitter, but he had that one big one at Veterans Stadium last year, a grand slam.
Got jammed on that pitch a little bit, but muscled it over the infield.
Zipped a bunt and took it low. Dickie will not be bunting here. I wouldn't think. One ball and one strike. That performance by Dennis Martinez last night at Pittsburgh.
One hitter. Barry Bonds got the hit in the seventh inning.
Against a good hitting ball club with some good left-hand hitters in Bonds and Van Slyke. O'Neill swings from both sides. LaValliere. Well, he's tried awfully hard to get Dennis Martinez this offseason. If the third might be two. Nope, low throw and a weak throw by Tom Herr, and Thon beats it out.
Looked like a double play ball when it was hit. It was hit sharply. Herr couldn't get much on the throw, and Thon hustled down the line. That takeout slide by Charlie Hayes probably prevented the double play. At least he put enough pressure on Herr to keep him from getting a strong throw to first.
Randy Reddy takes a fastball. Spike lifetime is hitless against Frank Viola, 0-for-10.
Oh,
Phillies have not hit Viola well at all since he came over from Minnesota. He had beaten him a couple games. He had a cut at that fastball, fouled it back. Now he'll probably get the fish, the changeup.
The dead fish.
It was, and he swings it into center field for a hit. Dickie Thon heading for third. And the Phillies have runners at first and third with two outs for Jason Grimsley. Grimsley a chance to help himself here as a lifetime 143 hitter.
Hit that right off the end of the bat.
Find a hole somewhere, buddy.
You see a lot of funky hits against pitchers with good off-speed pitches because the hitters get fooled so much.
Yeah, all three of the Phillies' hits have certainly not been of the line drive variety today. Took a fastball for a strike. Might be the last fastball he sees. Got another one. Took it.
Right down the middle of the plate, too.
Just waiting for the one he wants, Rich.
That's the pitch Jason likes too, is a fastball.
Surprised he took both of those pitches. Now he'll probably get that fish. Another fastball. Did not get his bat off the shoulder. Two strikeouts for Viola, no runs, two hits, no errors, and two left. You go to the bottom of the second, it's a nothing-nothing game. Now, Philly Fanatic is camped up on top of Veterans Stadium, and he'll be there until the Phillies come back home late tomorrow night following the third game of this series. He has the first ball to deliver on opening night, Philly's home opener on Friday night, in his own inimitable way. It'll be the Phils and the St. Louis Cardinals on Friday night. Good curveball, one and one. Celebrating the 20th anniversary of Veterans Stadium, the first battery at the vet will be on hand. Jim Bunning to throw out the first pitch. And Tim McCarver will receive that pitch. Timmy, of course, was Philly's first catcher at the vet. And all fans in attendance receive a Dr. Dirt and Mr. Clean poster featuring Lenny Dykstra and Dale Murphy. Compliments of IGA. In the gap in right center field. Dykstra over to cut it off. Brooks will get two on. Stand up double for Hubie Brooks. He scored the winning run in yesterday's game, and these fans are glad to see one of their originals back in New York. Good ball play.
Because they got that curveball up high and right through the middle of the plate. Seems like you never get away with a bad pitch. You think once in a while somebody would pop one of those up.
Howard Johnson 0 for 3 in the opener. He's been a tough out for Grimsley. 2 for 3 off Jason, including a home run. Better hitter from the left side than right. 1 and nothing. Our trivia question of the afternoon: who was the only National League pitcher to beat the Mets twice at Shea Stadium last year? Only one pitcher was able to accomplish that feat.
I think that was big Jose De Jesus, wasn't it?
You got it.
Yeah.
Jose De Jesus of the Phils will be pitching tomorrow's game against David Cone.
Here's a little trivia for you, Harry.
All right.
Sure you'll get it. Cy Young, for whom the pitching award is named for, on opening day pitched a total of three shutouts. A Phillies pitcher also did that on opening day.
Three times?
Three times.
That would have to be one of either two pitchers. Quick curveball, one of two. The man who started 12 games on opening day for the Phillies, Robin Roberts, would be the natural guess. But, it is so logical to guess, Robbie, that I will have to guess Chris Short.
I don't believe you knew that. Now, how did you know that?
Well, I remember the one he pitched at Houston's Astrodome in 65. That was my first year with Houston. Good curveball struck him out. Third strike out for Grimsley. One down here in the second. It'll bring up Mark Carrion.
Curveball that hurt him with Brooks, but it sure got him out of some trouble with Howard Johnson. That was Chris Short, and he pitched for the Phillies in the 50s, 60s, and 70s.
This guy's a pretty good-looking hitter, Carrion. Loves the fastball, and he misses the curveball. Jason's throwing a good breaking pitch. He's got a good deuce today. Carrion playing for the injured Kevin McReynolds. His dad was a major league catcher, Camilo Carrion. Dykstra down with the sunglasses makes the catch. Ruby Brooks will move up to third. And with two outs, it'll bring up Tom Hurd. Hurd went 0 for 2 yesterday.
Probably telling Grimsley, you know, don't lay the ball right in there to her. You have a couple bases open. You have a relatively weak hitter coming up next. And OBrien, the catcher.
Fastball in tight to him, 1-0. Nothing game playing in the bottom of the second. Breaking ball missing. 2-0.
Anywhere near the strike zone on the first three pitches, and now they're going to walk him intentionally.
That'll put Tom Herr out and bring up Charlie OBrien. OBrien was 0 for 3 yesterday. Fine defensive catcher who's never been much of a hitter.
Hit the ball hard yesterday twice.
They did.
Both of them caught.
good curveball. UB Brooks, runner at third base. Tom Herr at first. That's the same base runners that were on base yesterday in this situation with two outs, and they executed a double steal, which proved to be the winning run of the game. Would he?
Sure he would. Kidding? The pitcher coming up next. Even if it didn't work, he wouldn't have the pitcher leading off. If they're going to try it, this would be a good pitch to run.
Well, Brian is looking long at Mike Cubbage, the third base coach, so he very well could have something here. Looks like he's going to run. There he goes. No throw. Herr steals second base.
Tommy Herr has two stolen bases now. First two games. Stetch did look to third and decided, well, I won't throw it.
2-2 to OBrien. Missed very high with a curveball. Full count. Might still give him a 3-2 deuce with the pitcher Frank Viola due up next. He did, and he grounds it sharply foul.
That's a dangerous pitch, that curveball that starts out at the hitter. Now, if the hitter stays there and doesn't give any ground, that is a great pitch to hit. And OBrien, on two of those pitches, hasn't budged an inch.
Fastball that he cues off the end of his bat.
That was a good pitch. That was headed right for that outside corner, and it was a good fastball.
Well, the Mets have the bases loaded with two outs for pitcher Frank Viola. Like a lifetime 148 hitter, a chance to help himself here. On top of that plate. Time is called as Dalton and Grimsley can't seem to get together on what they want to throw.
I think they overreacted early.
I did too.
When Tommy Herr was the batter.
He was in a good rhythm at that time. Why?
Yeah, and then he got careful, which is all right, but he got so careful that he's lost the next two hitters.
The other day game in the major leagues today will be at Wrigley Field, Chicago, starting shortly. The Cubs and the St. Louis Cardinals in their opener. That's the action tonight. Montreal at Pittsburgh, the Dodgers at St. Louis, San Francisco at San Diego. Two quick strikes to Viola. American League Boston at Toronto, Cleveland to Kansas City, California at Seattle, and Minnesota at Oakland.
I think those Atlanta Braves are going to be a lot better this year. They have good young pitching.
In addition to Pendleton and Sabreen have to help him. He struck him out. Four strikeouts for Grimsley. No runs, one hit, no errors. Bases left loaded. We go to the third. It's a nothing-nothing game. Still time to get in on Phillies Action 91 by ordering a season ticket. They start as low as $84.50 for 13 games. There are 11 different plans for all types of budgets and schedules. See all the action from some of the best seats. Find out about the options and advantages of season tickets. Just call the Phillies sales office at 463-5000 weekdays from 9 to 5. Lenny Dykstra leads it off. He walked his first time up. Breaking ball missing. 1-0. One ball and one strike. Frank Viola won the Cy Young Award in the American League in 88.
That was a called swing, not a called strike on a non-swing and a half swing.
Missing with the fastball, 2-1. Spring in 24 innings, only walked one batter while striking out 12. He's in danger of walking Lenny Dykstra again. Poured that fastball over. Well, you don't know what Lenny might get. Necessarily get the heat. Viola will throw that change up anytime in the count. Fastball that he hits to deep center field, but Coleman makes the catch at the track. And Dykstra is out on a deep fly ball to center. There's Lenny talking to himself, and that'll bring up Darren Dalton. Dalton was called out on strikes his first time up. One thing is pretty certain, you're not going to hit the ball over the head of Vince Coleman.
Have to get it over the fence to get it over his head.
One.
I don't know why he plays so deep. He has such excellent speed. You know, he could play in much shallower and still get back on the ball.
Dalton just, when he hits a rope, he hits him foul. One and two.
Doesn't give the left-hand pitchers any ground at all, and some of those pitches are a little inside, and if you don't give ground and you swing at the inside pitch, the only place you can hit it is foul, is to pull it foul. Those pitches break over the plate, then you can hit them fair.
at that inside pitch. And it is a full count to Darren Dalton. Don Hayes waiting on deck. Dalton's called out on strikes for the second straight time. Third strikeout for Viola. All of them have been called third strikes.
It was a good pitch, too. It was a slider. He's made two perfect 3-2 pitches on Dalton. This last one was a little better than the first one. First one might have been a tad off the plate and was close.
Von Hayes slung a single to right his first time up, lays off the inside fastball. To a nothing. Jason Grimsley. In the shallow center, Coleman's speed won't get there because he plays so deep, and Hayes had first slide into second with a double. That's the kind of balls we're talking about, as deep as Coleman plays.
That should be an easy out. I mean, he ran a long way and still didn't catch up to the ball, and he's still pretty deep out there. That should really be a routine out.
Batter will be Dale Murphy. Murphy grounded out short to first, his first time up.
Hayes hasn't really hit the ball good yet today, but he has a couple of base hits and won a double.
He'll take him.
Sure, you line out a lot, you might as well get even somewhere.
And strike to Murphy.
On the corners and lives on borderline pitches. He just never throws one down the middle and says, here, hit it.
Miss that corner again. It's 2-1. Might be pitching carefully to Murphy. Left-hand hitting John Kruk is due up next. Game is underway at Wrigley Field. Bryn Smith for St. Louis and Danny Jackson for the Cubs. Cardinals failed in the first. Half swing foul, 2-2. Strikeouts for Viola. No runs, one hit, no errors, one left. We go to the bottom of the third, it's nothing, nothing.
Friday, April 12th, 7:35, the Phillies home opener. Always one of the biggest nights of the year. Enjoy the festivities. Watch the Phillies play the Cardinals and get a handsome Lenny Dykstra Dale Murphy poster courtesy of IGA. Call 463-1000.
Now this Sunday, a special giveaway item for all youngsters 14 and under. A pair of white Phillies batting gloves with red trim, just like the ones the players wear. Compliments of Homer's Cookies. For all youngsters 14 and under on Sunday, batting glove day at the Vet, Phillies and the Cardinals. Game time 1:35. For tickets, call 463-1000 or stop by one of the many local Ticketmaster outlets. 1-0 to Coleman. He tapped out to the mound his first time up. Ground ball, Krucker has it, he'll make the play himself. Coleman's out, one down, that'll bring up Greg Jeffries, who struck out his first time up. Gave Jeffries an awful lot of curveballs in that first at bat. Jeffries is a good baseball hitter. Very hard to get a heater by Jeffries, but a quick bat. Him with a breaking ball that missed. Fouls off that pitch. That was another breaking ball that hung up there a little bit.
Jeffries is a very emotional player. You always know how he's feeling, and whether he's happy or sad.
Two and one. Talking about the batting gloves. Are there any players anymore that don't wear batting gloves?
I think there's one, but I can't remember him. You know, we used to remark about it.
The deuce again, struck him right on out of there. The fifth strikeout for Jason Grimsley. He's nailed Jeffries twice with a good curveball.
And both of them were low. This one didn't bounce up there, but it was low.
It'll bring up Dave Magadan. He struck out his first time up. Starts him with a curveball. He's throwing that pitch for strikes. Fouls it back. Grimsley ahead of Maggot and nothing in two. Nothing game, bottom of the third. Half swing of the curveball. The appeal goes down to third base umpire Greg Bonan. Says no swing. 2-2. Count to Magadan with two outs. Very high with a fastball. Third walk given up by Grimsley. Magadan is a two-out base runner for Hubie Brooks, who doubled his first time up. Sports director Carl Churkin here at Shea today. been over the years one of the game's top RBI men. Good clutch hitter. Use that curveball foul. 1-1. Is look, here's a hitter without batting gloves. UB Brooks.
Ask, you yeah, shall receive.
Really?
This was a borderline. I guess Bruce Fleming thought it was low.
Chops the ball to Charlie Hayes. Charlie to Randy Reddy. A high throw. The spike makes the play at second. No runs, no hits, no errors, and one left. Andy Musser comes your way in the fourth. After three, it's nothing, nothing.
Even with the no-hitter, I'm never going to be a glamour guy. I just want to be a solid, dependable pitcher. A guy who gives 100% every time he gets the ball. To me, the mark of a good pitcher isn't one great game. It's a lot of good games.
All children 14 and under receive a pair of white batting gloves with red trim just like the players wear free. Sunday, April 14th at 1:35 when the Phillies play the Cardinals. Order tickets quickly and easily by calling 463-1000.
Phillies baseball is brought to you by Budweiser with that distinctively clean, crisp, cold taste. Nothing beats a Bud. And by the Bell of Pennsylvania Yellow Pages, no other book can match it. Bell of Pennsylvania, a Bell Atlantic company. And by Dodge, rediscover American values at your local Dodge dealer where it's advantage Dodge. And Andy Musser with us here in the fourth, Andy.
Kay Whitey and Carrion had to go over toward the line to catch that ball hit by Kruk, so there's one out in the scoreless game as we go to the fourth inning. Both pitchers really doing the job so far. Viola has four strikeouts. Grimsley has five. Charlie Hayes got his first hit of the year in his initial at-bat today, a single to center field. Has really developed into being a good third baseman. He led all major league, not just National League, but all major league third baseman in assists last year, 324 of them. One of which, well, no, it wasn't an assist, that was a put out, that line drive that he caught to end Terry Mulholland's no-hitter. Gary Carter at the plate. Headed for the hole, it goes on through. Jeffries went to his left but didn't really come close to it, and Charlie Hayes is two for two.
Phillies have out hit the Mets 5-1. They've had Viola in some trouble. Haven't been able to get the next hit though.
Dickie Thon will step in. Dickie with that hot spring training batting average. I think Dickie batted over 400. Well, he did. Look at yesterday's sheet, it says 408. Rounded into a fielder's choice in his only at bat today, and Bruce Fleming says that one's on the corner. And Dickie likes weather like this. It's really, it's just like we never left Florida, isn't it?
Or this is Florida without the wind.
Mm-hmm.
Nice little breeze today, but nothing like Florida.
It goes between O'Brien's legs, and Charlie Hayes takes second. Charlie didn't know where that was. A wild pitch.
The ball didn't roll far, just kind of rolled back by the umpire, Bruce Fleming, and Charlie Hayes heads up.
You know, I just heard the press PA say pass ball. I can't, and there it is on the scoreboard. I can't believe that. That ball bounced in front of the plate. Yeah, how can they call that a pass?
They'll change it.
They just saw our replay, I'm sure, didn't they? Now, Viola and OBrien want to get together here. Over the years, though, we have seen strange calls here at Shea Stadium. This is not one of the more consistent.
A lot of strange people here at Shea Stadium. Gene Mock used to say, you get unusual things out of unusual people.
Next pitch is low. It's two balls and a strike. Love to score first today. They'd never led in yesterday's game. Bond sends it to the outfield, but it looks like Hubie Brooks is going to have no trouble with this one, and Charlie Hayes has to stay put. Anything hit to the Mets outfield can be a bit of an adventure. Brooks makes the play. There are two out. They are gambling with their defense here, wouldn't you say?
I think definitely infield and outfield.
Mel Stottlemyre coming to the mound now.
Well, you got a pitcher coming up after Randy Reddy, who singled his first time up, and you know, you don't really have to tell Frank Viola what to do here, but I guess they want to make sure he knows the strategy.
That single for Reddy was the first one he'd ever gotten off Viola, at least in the National League. He had been 0 for 10 coming into the game. I don't know whether they faced one another in the American League or not. Walked just one today, and it was the first battery face, Dykstra.
I think they'll go ahead and walk him now. You know, they're obviously not anywhere near the strike zone on the first two pitches.
OBrien glances into his own dugout to see, but they're going to make at least one more pitch here. Brian again looks into the dugout, and it's going to be four. They're going to walk it. Now, Phillies employed the same strategy with Tommy Herr. That's an intentional walk.
And Jason once again with a chance to help himself. Up there in a good situation his last time up. Three straight fastballs with strikes.
Tom Browning certainly helped him in last night's or yesterday afternoon's game at Riverfront Stadium. Big hit for the Reds pitcher. Drove in three runs. Grimsley fouls it back just under our booth. Side, one ball and one strike. Grimsley is a good athlete with the opportunity to become a good hitter at some point in his career when he gets it figured out a little bit more. On the corner, one and two. Wrigley Field in Chicago, the only other National League game. Any other day game in baseball, the Cards and the Cubs scoreless in the top of the third. Two strikes on Phillies pitcher Jason Grimsley, who had three hits last year and two runs batted in. Well, Jason's getting a piece of it. Jason with the eye lays off that pitch. Viola wants to see him swing at a pitch out of the strike zone. I think he's made enough pitches now to realize that Grimsley can get some wood on the ball. And he's trying to get him to go for a bad pitch. But he's running out of margin for error here. Pretty good at that by Jason.
Getting mostly fastballs to hit, too. And as you mentioned, he's a pretty good athlete. Someday he's going to hit a home run in the major leagues because he's big and strong enough and quick enough with the bat. I have a feeling if Viola threw him anything else but the fastball, he might not hit it.
Step off. Nobody is covering first. So that was a bluff. Magadan is playing well behind Reddy. A piece of it again. If nothing else, at least he is tiring Frank Viola. Mel Stottlemyre. Tommy Herr. Tommy blocked it, makes the play over to first, and Grimsley, after a fine at bat, grounds out. No runs, one hit, and two men left on base. Go to the bottom of the fourth, still looking for a run.
Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to.
Home opener just around the corner, Friday night, 7:35 against the Cardinals. The Fanatic so excited about it, he's already camping out on the catwalk at the roof of Veterans Stadium, awaiting the first pitch and awaiting the Phillies to come home by bus Wednesday night from Shea Stadium. Order your tickets easily. Call 463-1000. Phillies in the Cards. Here we are, nothing-nothing, as Howard Johnson leads off the bottom of the fourth. First pitch misses. Howard struck out in his first at-bat against Grimsley. Jason has five strikeouts. Joe's still looking for his first hit this year. He was 0 for 3 yesterday.
Trying to bunt that little old curveball. That's a good pitch to bunt because it's, you know, it's slow and it's looping towards the ground. Don't see Howard Johnson bunt very much, but he can bunt, and he's a pretty good runner.
Real good stolen baseman. And Jason Grimsley fans him on that same pitch he just tried to bunt. number six.
The hitters know what Grimsley's doing. They know that he's throwing a lot of curveballs, but they're still not hitting it. That was a good one.
In steps Mark Carrion. He flied out to center field in his only plate appearance today. Takes a strike. Kevin McReynolds is day-to-day. Hurt a kneecap yesterday, legging out a ground ball. Chased a pitch well out of the strike zone on that 0-2 delivery and just got a piece of it. Grimsley has, for the most part, worked ahead of the hitters. He's issued three walks today, one intentional. Grounded to third. Tough play for Charlie Hayes, and he kicks it. That'll be a base hit. No advance by Carrion. Only the second hit for New York in their first single.
Grimsley made a pretty good pitch here. Charlie dropped it and then kicked it, but I'm not sure he could have thrown Carrion out even had he fielded cleanly, because he was deep and over towards the line.
Carrion at first, one away. Tommy Herr steps in. The Phillies tried to get him to chase a bad pitch last time. When they got behind him in the count 3-0, they issued the intentional walk. We are scoreless in the fourth. Carrion runs. Herr swings and misses. No throw. Stolen base, Carrion.
That's playing hit and run, and Herr didn't really have anything to hit there. Alton couldn't find the handle on the ball.
Pitch by Grimsley, a pitcher's pitch. So it's 0-2 on Tommy, who hasn't had anything to hit in this at bat. Breaking ball. What a great catch by Dalton. You could see that thing skipping on by, couldn't you? Catch, Darren. Watch this.
The ball bounced right up there in front of the plate, and those are tough. Picked it clean.
Mets fans want to see some runs. Their team scored two yesterday and led 2-0. Then the home run by Kruk cut it, and that's all the scoring there was here yesterday. Nothing so far today. Trying to backdoor him, but missed. That was close. Pause here for station identification. You're watching the Phillies Television Network.
WTXF, Fox 29 in Philadelphia.
In the fourth inning at Shea Stadium, it's 0-0, Phillies and the Mets. Phillies with five hits, New York two. You're seeing a pretty good at-bat here by Tom Herr, who actually gave up one strike on that hit-and-run attempt. Got behind in the count 0-2 and now has worked it level. Grimsley at Scranton Wilkes-Barre last year pitched 22 games there. Then later 11 games with the Phillies. In the air to right field. Murphy had a late start, but he's there. Dale couldn't seem to get going on that. And carry on remains at second base, two out.
I think it's that sod out there. You know, it's beautiful, but it's a little soft. Murphy spun his wheels just briefly.
Charlie O'Brien gets up. Seems like he's always getting up there with some men on base yesterday and today. Drew a walk in his only plate appearance in this game. It was O'Brien, of course, who was at bat yesterday when the Mets pulled that double steal. Ball one. Ball grounded, foul past third. Good thing too, because it didn't look like Charlie Hayes was going to be in a spot to field it. One ball, one strike on Charlie O'Brien. Philly's third sacker Charlie Hayes gets everything coming his way for the most part. He's turned into a real good third baseman, and Nick Leyva forecasts a gold glove in his future somewhere. Tim Wallach won it last year as third baseman in the National League. Two on O'Brien.
Grimsley's fastball really isn't even straight. It kind of sails or slides a little bit. I don't think he can throw a true straight pitch. Ball really moves.
And that's a tremendous advantage for a pitcher. Some guys throw real hard, but their ball is straight, and that means it's hittable.
Just off the plate, I guess.
See what you think.
Yeah, see Dalton setting up there. Now that's probably off the plate a little bit, but that was a good pitch to throw.
Took something off that one and gets him. That's number 7 in the K column for Jason Grimsley. No runs, one hit. And one left. Through four, nothing.
They say the neon lights are bright on Broadway.
On Broadway.
They say there's always magic in the air.
Kids opening day. This Saturday, April 13th, Phillies and the Cards meet in a 135 game at Veterans Stadium, and it features a Phillies batting helmet cereal bowl and a box of Kellogg's cereal for all children 14 and under. They plan to bring out the whole family. Call and order tickets easily by phone, 463-1000, or you can stop by the Phillies Center City ticket office at Core State's First Pennsylvania Bank, Center Square. Dykstra today has walked and fly deep to center field. It's a nothing-nothing game. Lifetime against Viola. Lenny is 4-for-19. Two strikes on Lenny. We mentioned that Jason Grimsley has 7 strikeouts. That ties his career high. Jason had 7 at Montreal on September 28th of last year, as Rich Ashburn reminded me, with that steel trap of a mind. And confirmed by going to Larry Shank's Prescott. Two and two.
Viola keeps trying to pitch the left-hand hitters in hard. Does it to Dykstra, did it to Hayes and Kruk. And Dalton, of course. Dalton's been pulling a lot of those pitches. Foul.
The 2-2. Another full count for Dykstra. He's had that in, what, 80% of his at-bats in, you know, spring training in here?
Three today. All three today have gone full. Threw a walk and hit a ball hard to center field.
And what is really remarkable is how many full counts he's had after getting behind 0-2. Slapped up the middle. Hojo can't get it. It's a base hit. The first of 1991 for Len Dykstra. The Phillies' sixth hit.
He stung this ball. Pretty good pitch by Viola, slider. You see Howard Johnson diving. The ball got under his glove.
Aaron Dalton today twice called out on strikes. He's around to bunt, takes high. The Phillies want that first run today. Larry Boa lets him know what's on. Speaking of runs, there are still none at Wrigley Field in Chicago. The Cubs and the Cards and their opener are in the fourth inning.
Like Dalton's up there to bunt again. I don't think that's a good idea. You gotta let him hit.
He heard you. You got a hotline to Nick Lava, do you?
No, it looked like when Viola made his move to first on Dykstra that Dutch had started his square around, you know. You see Boa going through bunch of signs. I don't think he'll be bunting.
And it's 3-0 on Darren. Part of the order coming up. Hayes on deck. So maybe this will be the inning where the Phillies get ahead for the first time here on 91. They were never ahead in yesterday's game. Taking that one all the way. On the last year of his contract, Mets have made him a good offer.
Over $13 million on a three-year contract.
You'd have to gulp a little bit before you'd say no, that's not quite enough, wouldn't you?
Walked away from it with chips in his arm.
Yeah. That is a real calculated risk. Dykstra goes and Dalton fouls it back, so now we've got a full count. You had Tim McCarver on your pregame radio show today, and Timmy flat out said that is a real game. He says, in fact, the way Timmy put it was, he says, I think that Viola is at more risk than the Mets in this situation.
Yeah, well put, and I think he's right. Chips aren't, I guess, that serious these days. There's our good friend Timmy.
Timmy the Mac.
Who started his great career in Philadelphia.
As a broadcaster, you mean?
Yes.
Because his playing career did not start in Philadelphia. However, it did conclude there. Up the middle, fielded by Hojo, make the play over to first for the out. So by running, Dykstra gets to second base. That's the first out.
Was amazing about that, but Howard Johnson was kind of heading towards second to cover. Kind of floated right into the ground ball. But he covered a little late, and I think that's what those infielders should do. A lot of them break so quickly and they leave the hole wide open.
Now here's Von Hayes. He's 2 for 2 today, a single and a double. They're both were kind of dunkers, but Von will take them and swings through this pitch. So Hayes is the only Philly who has 3 hits so far this season. The Phillies have out-hit the Mets 6-2, but neither team has scored. Would get 2 hits today because, needless to say, the left-hander Viola is a tough customer on lefties, and Bond came into the game 3 for 20 off Viola. Missed with it, 2-1. Full year as the skipper here. One time Mets shortstop and a good one, Buddy Harrelson. Hayes fouls it back. Just glancing at the rosters in the Inquirer this morning, keeping up on some of the ex-Phils. Mike Maddox has made the pitching staff of the San Diego Padres, and Don Carmen is on the staff of the Cincinnati Reds. Isn't it interesting that the Houston Astros didn't have a place for Carmen, but the Reds do? Steps off. Hojo had gone in behind Dykstra.
Cincinnati might put that Norm Charlton back in their rotation now, then. Put Carmen in the bullpen.
Right. And Charlton is in the rotation to start the year.
Another full count, 3 in this inning.
Murphy waiting. Coach John Vukovic. No, Bill Giles took 20 of his closest friends out to dinner last night. Good thing we had a private room, because it turned into a little bit of a storytelling session as you and Johnny Padres had the floor. Nice going, Whitey. Usually get paid.
Well, I was thrust out on the floor. I really was a reluctant participant.
Johnny Padres. Usually get paid for performances like that, don't you?
It was a good dinner. At a little kind of a shabby little place over there on 52nd, 54th, 52nd.
52nd, it was reviewed. We're talking about the 21 Club. It was reviewed in the New York Times a week ago Friday, and one of the lines in the Times was that it is astonishingly expensive.
Stephanie Hayes, Bond's new bride.
Frank Viola wins this one. He gets strikeout number 5, 2 out in the inning.
It's Viola who seems to be coming out of most of these confrontations. He's been in some trouble, but he's always able to get that key hitter out. That was a good pitch, 3-2 slider.
In steps Dale Murphy, 0-2 this afternoon. He struck out last time up after grounding to shortstop. OBrien will talk it over with Viola before they pitch to Murph. probably oughtn't to do any lip reading right here.
Well, you have to give the pitcher credit there. He made a great pitch, and Vaughn, you know, battled him all the way.
He bet he did. Now let's see what Murphy can do. Fly ball to right field. Brooks gets there. Murphy flies to right, and the Phillies are down. No runs, one hit, one left. Bottom of the fifth coming up. Five. It is a scoreless game.
Epic saga of a new frontier.
Yo, go on now.
A pioneer family pursued by a gang of killers.
These men want our blood.
Their only hope lies in the guts and the gun of a stranger.
Meek ain't gonna inherit nothing west of Chicago.
Sam Elliott, Kate Capshaw, Tom Conti. Louis L'Amour's Western classic, The Quick and the Dead.
Tonight at 8 on Fox 29.
It's overcast at Shea Stadium right now. There is the threat of a shower at any point this afternoon, but there's not going to be steady rain by any means. It's a nothing-nothing game. Frank Viola, the Mets pitcher, gets a nice hand. He'll be the leadoff hitter here in the bottom half of the inning. Frank struck out the first time he faced Grimsley. For a guy that came over from the American League and has just been in the National League 2 years, he's not a bad hitter. He has 16 hits already in the little less than 2 years he's been in the league.
Hi, V.
I got a stat on the board that says the Mets were 63-26 last year when they scored the first run. Amazing how often the team that scores the first run wins the game.
Especially when you have that kind of pitching.
But I mean, even poor teams.
Well, that's true, yeah.
You're right, but of course, in the Mets, yeah, the first run would look huge, and I think that's why the Phillies even considered bunting with Dalton there that one time.
I'll wait, dude.
2-2. Even if you get a run on the first, then the other team automatically has to get two runs somewhere to beat you. Jamie Moyer is going to pitch that game for the Cardinals on Friday night at Veterans Stadium. He'll be matched up against Pat Combs. Full count. Terry Mulholland comes back to pitch Saturday afternoon against Bob Tewksbury. Dave LaPointe gets his first start Sunday against Bryn Smith, today's pitcher for the Cards. Strikeout number 8, a career high for Jason Grimsley.
Well, he only threw about one good pitch to Viola, and that was the 3-2 pitch that struck him out. The others were all over the place.
He's gotten Coleman with ease today on a comebacker to the mound and a ground ball to first. So Vince is 0-2. And again, Charlie Hayes will come up on that grass. Coleman couldn't get number 29 because today's pitcher, Frank Viola, has it. Finney always wore 29 with the Cardinals. You know who absolutely does not care about numbers at all is John Kruk. He's going to change again now. He's going to give Mitch Williams his 28. John had two numbers last year, so that'll make two more numbers for him this year. You're going to see him sporting 29, I think. I think he's going to just exchange with Mitch. They ever retire his number, they'll have to retire a bunch of them. Grimsley gets Coleman strikeout number 9. We're in the fifth inning.
He got some help from Coleman there. Coleman came swinging a strike. Ball was low.
Well, Jeffries has already gone down on strikes twice. Not since the first inning has Grimsley been able to get him 1-2-3. Got a shot here. 0-2 on Jeffries.
That was close. The outside corner.
Bounce it, Ryan. It's 2-2 now on Jeffries. The Phillies were ready to make Dennis Martinez an offer in the offseason had he become available, and last night we got a little indication why, as he pitched a whale of a game for the Expos, a one-hitter for 7 innings against the Pirates. Caught by Randy Reddy. Jeffries lines out and the Mets go 1-2-3, and after 5 it's nothing.
All children 14 and under receive a pair of white batting gloves with red trim just like the players wear free. Sunday, April 14th at 1:35 when the Phillies play the Cardinals. Order tickets quickly and easily by calling 463-1000.
Going to take a look at the pitcher's numbers in this game, and Jason Grimsley all the better of it. He's given up 4 fewer hits than Viola, and he has 9 strikeouts, representing a career high. The only column that's at a slight disadvantage is that he has issued one more walk than Frank, but one of those walks was intentional. And so we go to the sixth. Somebody's going to score a run sometime. John Kruk, who has accounted for the only Phillies run this year with a home run, leading off the fifth inning yesterday, now bats as a leadoff hitter here in the sixth. Kruk, Charlie Hayes, Dickie Thon. Green gets up in the bullpen. Speaking of Green, he is going to be, in addition to a middle inning guy, also a spot starter. In that number 5 spot in the rotation where LaPointe gets the first start on Sunday, there have been times, and LaPointe knows this as well as Green does, that a right-hander would be better for the Phillies than a left-hander, and in that case, Green will get the nod. And so we might be seeing LaPointe used some in relief as well. Cardinals have a run at Wrigley Field and they lead 1-0, top half of the fifth inning. Grimsley's done a tremendous job today. Career high 9 strikeouts, and he's pitched 5 innings. Hit for Kruk. Second inning in a row, the Phillies have had their leadoff man on. Last inning it was Dykstra who got to second, but no further. Hit number 7 for the Phillies.
Excellent at bat by John Kruk. He had some tough pitches to swing at. He gets the barrel of the bat on the ball about as well as anybody in the lineup.
Charlie Hayes, the Hayeses have been hot. He and Vaughn have four of the seven Phillies hits today, two apiece. Ooh, Larry Boa was bailing, and who can blame him? Pretty good stop.
Well, it was. I mean, that was a bullet. Stunner.
Charlie took the collar yesterday. She's smiling. Yeah, I felt that. Yeah, you bet. Ball and a strike on Charlie Hayes. Goes, and the ball is hit to shortstop. Howard Johnson has only the play to first. This is a carbon copy of last inning.
Phillies just can't get a break on those hit and runs. They're, you know, the Mets are covering second with the right player and can't get that hole.
In steps Dickie Thon. Dickie out on a ground ball to third. It was turned into a fielder's choice and a fly ball to right field. Mets are getting some bullpen action now. Innes is the right-hander and Pete Shurik is the left-hander. Ties a shoelace. A 1-1 count on Thon. Dickey with one of the hottest springs of any of the Phillies. In fact, he led the Phillies in hits with 31 in spring training, but looking for number one in the season. Be a good spot for it. On the corner, says Fremming. 1-2. Six for Viola, second out of the inning.
That was a bad pitch. It was a changeup that downed quite a bit. Dickie fooled on it.
Kruk is at second base, but now with two out. Randy Reddy steps in. Randy today has singled and drawn an intentional walk.
Nick Leva has Ricky Jordan out in the on-deck circle here. Doesn't necessarily mean, well, they're going to walk Reddy and whatever. They're probably going to chalk it over.
Yeah.
That's what they were going to do.
Stottlemyre wants to see how Viola feels about it, I guess.
Well, I think Ricky Jordan in the on-deck circle has kind of made the Mets wonder here. If they pitched to Reddy and got him out, I think Grimsley would come out for another inning. But if they do walk Reddy or Reddy can deliver, then they might go to Ricky Jordan. I think Buddy Harrelson would like to get Jason Grimsley out of the ballgame.
They're going to pitch to Randy. Maybe a little miscommunication on the part of the Mets, but now they're going to pitch to him. Cubs have tied the Cardinals. It's 1-1, last of the fifth at Wrigley. So Viola gets ahead in the count, nothing and two on the Phillies platoon second baseman, and Jason Grimsley may or may not be out of the game. We'll have to see, but if he is out, he pitched five tremendous innings, giving up only two hits and striking out a career best nine.
Yeah, you know, most of these pitchers haven't pitched that long this spring, and they're not going to start them out trying to get eight or nine innings out of them, although Gooden went eight last night. And Mulholland went seven strong innings.
Hard hit, base hit. Over to third base goes Kruk. They're going to try to score him. Brooks's throw. Safe. Phillies lead 1-0. The throw sends Reddy to second base. They were going to walk him, and they pay the price for not doing so.
Oh, what a nice at-bat by Randy Reddy. He was down 0-2 in the count. Took that outside pitch the other way. Did a nice piece of base running also. Strong throw by Hubie, a little bit up the line, and that grass really makes the ball check up. O'Brien just couldn't get... He got the mitt back there, but he didn't have the ball in it.
That gets Jason Grimsley up to the plate. Jason fouls it back. Grimsley has been called out on strikes and has grounded to second. For the first time in 91, Randy Reddy has given the Phillies a lead. It's 1-0 Phillies. Two on Jason. Phillies have had hits in every inning against Viola, and eight for the game now. They've outhit the Mets 8-2, finally cashing in. Sure, Nick feels better, but not altogether comfortable about this either.
Can't quite mail it in yet.
No. On the ground to shortstop, Howard Johnson plays it. Grimsley is out, but the Phillies have the first run of the afternoon on two hits with one left. And the Mets come up in the sixth, trailing 1-0. Phillies baseball is brought to you by Ford. Bank on your Quality Plus Ford dealer for great savings during Leadership Month. And by U.S. Healthcare, a health plan for living. Now the Phillies have a 1-0 lead, and Grimsley is still on the mound. For the Mets here in the sixth, Magadan, Brooks, and Johnson. Magadan, a strikeout and a walk in this game today. Three batters that Grimsley has not struck out are Brooks, Carrion, and Herr. That was close, but it's two balls and no strikes. Jason Grimsley pitched probably his finest game of spring training against these Mets. He tried to overthrow there. And he's behind in the count 3-0, and Padres wants more action in the bullpen. Tommy Green had been up before. We'll see who it is now. Inasmuch as it's one inning later, it may or may not be Green again. Ackerfels. He and Sandy Koufax were and Don Drysdale were all members of the Dodgers, Padres.
Oh, sure.
And he and Double D were close friends. All four. Walk number four issued by Grimsley. Only the second time in the game the Mets have had their leadoff man on. And the other time it happened, the batter at the plate did it. Hubie Brooks. Hubie has doubled and grounded into a fielder's choice. Curveball for a strike. Hubie, an infielder when he was here in New York the last time around, started playing outfield with Montreal. After the Mets acquired Darryl Strawberry this last winter, there was some talk that Hubie might return to third base for the Dodgers, but it never really got to the serious point. Dodgers starting the season now with Jeff Hamilton at third base. Breaking ball popped up, shallow right. Can Reddy get back? Oh, a juggling catch. It looked like he was about to give way to Murphy and then caught it at the last instant. Whoa.
That's not an easy play for a second baseman. Kind of poked that glove out and found it. There it is. Sometimes it surprises you when it's in your glove. It was a key out.
Absolutely. Nice play by Randy Reddy, ranging to the outfield. And now Howard Johnson, who has struck out twice today. Howard's 0 for 5 on the year. He is the most fearsome bat when you think of long ball in this New York lineup. Hubie Brooks also represents a home run threat. In the air to left field, Hayes coming. Did he hang on? Yes, a catch. A tumble after the catch, but it was rung up right away by the third base umpire, Greg Bonin.
And that was not an easy play by any means. Bonin had to get his glove under that ball before it hit the grass.
And then keep it in there.
Yeah, keep it in there.
Bonin waited to see after the roll whether he still had it. Look at Vaughn covering up and protecting that to make sure it stays in the trap. Carrion takes outside, ball one. Mets outfielder has flied to center and picked up an infield hit and then stole a base. Vaughn Hayes, you know, the Phillies have moved Hayes to quite a few positions over the years. And whenever he's been left in one spot for a while, he develops it. You know, he learns how to play it pretty well. He became a pretty good first baseman, too. Phillies have played him in right, center, and now left. And he's becoming a pretty good left fielder.
Didn't he play a few games at third?
Oh, yeah. Sure. They're turning the lights on here at Shea Stadium.
Of course, the sun is coming
out. Right, as soon as they... Good timing. In the air to right center. Murphy makes the play. Carrion is out, and the Mets go in order here in the sixth. We'll move to the seventh with the Phillies holding a 1-0 lead.
Budweiser cordially invites you to a party at Trump Plaza. Dress is casual. Punch will be served. And there will be plenty of Budweiser on hand. Budweiser presents Holyfield versus Foreman. April 19th at Trump Plaza.
Let's party.
The Undisputed Heavyweight Championship. Brought to you by the Undisputed King of Beers.
Budweiser and Fox 29 are going to name a designated Bud batter before the seventh inning of every regular season game televised by Fox 29. If any Phillies player hits a home run during that inning, the designated Bud batter earns $100 immediately and shares in a bonus pool given out at the end of the season. If you are 21 or older, you can send your name, address, and telephone number to Bud Banner's Box, Post Office Box 13229, St. Louis, Missouri. We have a new pitcher coming on for New York, a double switch. Darryl Boston is coming in to play left field, replacing Mark Carrion. He will bat in the number 9 spot. And the new pitcher is Pete Shurick, a rookie left-hander. One of two rookie southpaws to make this Met team this year. He is a 21-year-old and delivers a strike to Lenny Dykstra. Shurick, 6'5", 195-pounder. Comes from Falls Church, Virginia. Last year at Jackson, 11-4 as a starter with a 3.04 ERA. Two quick strikes to Dykstra. He had a good strikeout walk ratio, 94 strikeouts, 39 walks in 124 innings. He was also 1-0 for Tidewater. This is his major league debut. Lenny Dykstra is 1 out of 2. His walk fly to deep center and single. He's in the hole, nothing and two to this young left-hander, Shurick. Wide. So Frank Viola going six innings, charged with one run on eight hits. He struck out six while walking two. The strikeouts in this game, Grimsley has struck out 9. Career high for Jason. Ground ball in the hole, flagged by Magadan to Shurick, covering in time to get Dykstra. That's one down, and that'll bring up Darren Dalton. Darren Dalton has struck out twice and grounded out. Phillies lead 1-0. We are in the seventh. All out of play. One ball and one strike to Darren Dalton. Center field, Vince Coleman. Right there. Dalton's out, two down, and that'll bring up Bon Hayes, who has singled, doubled, and struck out. The Phillies are going to be seeing a lot of this year in the National League.
Lefties?
Lefties coming out of the bullpen, yep. With Dykstra, Dalton, Kruk, Hayes.
They'll be coming out of the woodwork. They'll be coming out of the minor leagues.
Changeup he throws. Seems to be able to throw it for strikes. Inside with a fastball. 1-1. Phillies lead 1-0. We are in the seventh inning. Side 2-1. Yeah. 2 balls and 2 strikes. They have those ball girls positioned too shallow here at Shea. Hit balls getting by him. Full count. Dale Murphy waiting on deck. Hayes walks. He's a two-out base runner for Dale Murphy. Murphy has grounded out, struck out, and flied out to right. The young left-hander. Chops a ball foul third base side. And one to Murphy. Von Hayes, runner at first base. 2 outs here in the 7th. One strike to Murphy.
Pitch right there.
Nothing in two.
Curveball he throws there.
Von Hayes at first base with 2 outs. Two strikes to Dale Murphy. Murphy caught looking on an off-speed pitch outside corner, and that'll retire the side. No runs, no hits, no errors, and one left. Stretch time at Shea, bottom of the 7th. It's 1-0 Phillies.
First-ever Phillies opening day just for kids. Saturday, April 13th, 1:35. The Phillies play the Cards. Kids 14 and under get a free cereal bowl that looks like a helmet and a box of Kellogg's cereal. Call 463-1000.
Tom Hurley leads it off for over New York. Phillies leading 1-0. Moore has been intentionally walked. He has flied out to right field. One strike to Tom Herr. He fists a pop up in the shallow right. Spike Reddy drifts out, makes the play easily. That's one down, and that'll bring on Charlie O'Brien. Randy Reddy's knocked in, the only run of this game, a two-run single. In the sixth, O'Brien has walked and struck out. Right.